Anderson of the New Harvest Christian Center in Anniston, Alabama. We will be right back. Minutes past the hour here on 91.9 FM WLJS Jacksonville. I'm sitting here with Pastor James Patterson, who is the pastor of New Harvest Christian Center in Anniston, Alabama. Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we are talking about college freshmen in America, how to be a successful college freshman, as well as some of the dangers that come with being a college freshman, the do's and don'ts of freshman life, and how to make it. One thing that I can definitely say about my freshman year in college was that it was a growing experience. It was a maturing experience. And did I always make the right decisions? No. But one thing I can say is that I learned from it. And I think Pastor here would agree with me when I say that I think that's what matters, is that you do learn from mistakes and that you become stronger from them. And once you realize it, what you did or used to do doesn't work, you try something new. And when you see that that new thing that you do works, then you stick with that. Would you agree with that, Pastor?
Yes, that's correct.
That's what I live by. That's truly what I live by. Pastor, I want to ask you, as a parent, what are your opinions about the relationships that freshmen have with their parents before going off to school? Do you feel that that relationship is important, maybe not so important?
Well, I believe that the relationship is very, very important, because a lot of who a child's or a person's parents are, it goes along with the development of that child's character. My temperament, my wife's temperament, and my daughter being raised up in our home, some kind of way between the combination of my wife and I, we began to form the character and the temperament of my daughter. And so we need to be able to speak one to another and understand the temperaments of our child, so that just in case if something does happen, we'll know. If something happens and we get a word back, we'll know, no, that's not my daughter. Or, yeah, that's more so her speed, or whatever the case may be, just to know exactly who your child is. And then your child also has to be in a position to where if something does go wrong, they know, hey, I have support.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I am the authoritative figure in my home, and my wife takes the lesser role as far as the discipline is concerned. So might be a little bit reluctant to talk to dad unless it's something major, but at the same time, my wife is available at all times. And so, that relationship, no matter what happened, they do what she has somebody, that she know that she can speak to. And I can't tell you why sometimes fathers, have that little bit of estrangedness, but the children always want to prove, father, hey, I can do what you asked me to do. And mother has to just go back in there sometimes and reiterate, you know, your dad asked you to do. We got to have those relationships open. We have to. Very, very important. And somebody like yourself and these young people that was in here speaking, and just in case there's some high school kids listening right now, please, the advice of your parents, no matter what you think, is usually better than that person sitting next to you.
Mm-hmm.
You may not believe that right now, but I promise you that advice that your parents give you will take you further than your neighbor.
Yeah. You're almost speaking the same words that my mother and father speak to me all of the time. And you know something that's funny? I'll be 20 years old in August, and I now look back on all those years of me hating my parents and me, oh, God, mom and dad, you get on my nerves. Oh, mom and dad, I can't stand you. And now it's like they were right.
Yeah.
They were right. And I think a part of me, I had to be removed from the comfort of home, the comfort of no responsibilities,
yes,
to realize that they were right about the dangers of this world. Because college is the world.
Yeah.
As far as I'm concerned, anywhere outside of the home of your parents is the world. And there's so much out there. And a part of me had wished that I had taken my parents' wisdom earlier in my life. Parts of my childhood probably could have ended up a whole lot better. But I'm not bitter at all. I'm not bitter. I'm better.
Okay.
I understand that, okay, you better listen to mama when she tells you don't hang out with this guy.
Yeah.
You better listen to dad when he tells you, son, be careful who you hang out with. You better listen when they tell you, son, make sure you understand the consequences of doing things as an adult.
Yes.
They don't send you to the kiddie jail anymore. You go to jail with the big boys.
Yes.
As a parent, do you feel that you and your daughter have a good close bond before she's going off to college? And how do you hope to retain that good bond? And the reason why I ask you this, because I'm sure there are a lot of parents out there who are wondering, how do they keep that close bond with their parents? Excuse me. How do they keep that close bond with their children?
Yes.
As they go off to college.
As you were speaking there, I just remembered something old that my mother used to say. She used to say, "You don't believe fat meat greasy, do you?" You know, said basically saying my words carry weight, and one way or another, you're gonna realize that what I'm telling you is the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Just to reiterate, just for a minute. I really can't speak from a woman's perspective right now coming into her own, but I know all you parents out there that may have young men that you're raising up, it may be a single mother out there, single mothers out there, and you don't have a husband there to help you nurture that young man, or maybe he is there, but he takes the lesser role. But when a young man comes into adolescence, he's coming into maturity, puberty, and all these things. You have to remember, if you have a dog outside, you know, when you first get that little dog, he's very aggressive anyway. But once he begins to get in the stage where the dog gets testosterone built up in him, you notice that your dog gets a little bit more aggressive. And you wonder what's wrong with him. But what's happening is that this thing called testosterone on the inside of him begins to make him more active, more easily agitated, and he must find a way to release himself through activities. You know, you need to go walk the dog, run the dog, or something like that. I use the dog right there for this simple reason. Males are, we're not dogs, you know, contrary to what many might believe. But at the same time, when a young man comes into his own, it's almost like a lion. He's ready to roar out there. You know, I want my freedom. I want to be free. And a lot of times when mom, dad begins to tell us different from what we want to do, we begin to want to resist them. And then out of this resistance, we build up this resentment. And mom, them don't know what they're talking about. Get on out of here. A lot of times parents need to understand how to deal with their child in that level. And then as far as the female is concerned, we still need to learn how to balance our rearing of our children so that we can continue to keep a open line of communication. Because no matter what happens, at the end of the day, if there's no communication, we all will fade away. We have to communicate at some point in our lives with one another in order to succeed. And so as far as my daughter's concerned, you know, I think that my relationship is good with her. Number one is, parents, if you're going to chastise your children and discipline them and get on them about doing the right thing, number one, you must be an example. If you're not an example, your children, oh my goodness, teenagers, young people will look at you as hypocritical. How can she tell me this when she's doing what she's telling me not to do? You have to line yourself up and say, you know what? For this season of your life, I will be the best example I can be for you so that you can trust and take me at my word. My word is the most powerful thing I have in my life as a parent, because I'm the one who speaks life into you. When you don't have nobody else to turn to, that parent is there to say, baby, it's going to be okay. And that child has to realize that when mama and daddy speaks those words, there's power in those words.
As a parent, do you feel that it is important to you know, in the summer months right after graduation, June, July, maybe a little bit of August, do you feel that it is important to give that child their, that sense of freedom, maybe letting them go out a little bit later or doing more than they would normally do, considering the fact that they're going to have to learn how to do it once they get to college anyway? Do you think that it's like, okay, that's kind of like their practice period of learning how to be adults and go out with people that you may not necessarily know who they are, and it could be a practice period